So on the trip, I took just a digital camera here, my Mamiya C330, and a Pentax MX. And this was, I believe, the first or second roll I shot through the MX. I think it was the second, because I think I shot a test roll first. Anyway, I digress. So, in the C330, I had a roll of Portra 160 220, which I don't ever shoot portraits. Like, I'm not a huge fan of it, but I loved the shots I got with this. I understand why people like it now. I don't think I enjoy Portra 400 or 800 as much as other people do, but this 160 was... And this is obviously expired. This is not the roll, but this one expired in 2007, because I don't think anyone makes 220 film anymore. Basically, this is just double 120, if that makes sense. So whereas like in a 6x6, a 120 is 12 shots, this is 24. So great stuff with this. And then in the MX, I had this. Yeah, my experience with this was not good. As you can tell, the photos came out like virtually unusable. There was a huge like color distortion going on, and then just no detail whatsoever. And I shot it, like everything was shot on exposure, so that wasn't the issue that I could think of. The camera works fine. That's the camera I took to England with me, and all of those rolls came out fine, but I digress. Some people have really liked it. I've seen some good pictures with it, so maybe it was just like a bad roll that I got. Because I think that Film Photography Project just recans old film. Could be mistaken on that. Either way, not impressed. Kind of lame experience. This actually made it on the short list of things that I didn't enjoy about last year, because overall, like, it was a pretty good year. So I'm kind of nitpicking for cons. But, you know, live and learn. This, on the other hand, just incredible. Portra 160. Okay, yeah. But yeah, overall, we caught zero fish. We ended up, I think we casted like 10 times in total. And every time we did, like, it would just get all, the line would just get all bundled up and turn into a bit of a rat's nest. Might go fishing again in the future. We'll definitely hang out with my friend in the future. Little roll review as well. And you can see in this one shot of my friend fishing, it's just like totally blown out in this, the right side of the frame. Whereas in the other shots, like, you can tell that in the background, like, these trees are pretty white. It was a very like sunny day. There was no real cloud coverage, so it was kind of harsh lighting. So this, like, it's not, why is it like this? But there's just zero definition whatsoever. And I find that to be incredibly alarming. Down towards the bottom of the frame, you can see that there's some coloring going on, but for the most part, it's like, what are we doing here? And it's slide film too, by the way. I don't know if I mentioned that. In slide film, color positive film, there's more layers. So obviously it's affected a lot more by things like aging and heat and all of these different elements. But also something to note about slide film that everybody pretty much knows, but in case you don't, the exposure latitude of it is greatly minimized. So whereas like normal negative film, you probably have like, you know, a few stops of dynamic range. So if like you shoot something on exposure, you're still gonna get a good amount of detail in the shadows and get some detail in the highlights. However, with this, you can tell that there is just no detail down here whatsoever. And even here in the highlights, like, it's still super grainy. Like, there's no purpose to this photo whatsoever. Like, there's no reason. And also, like, the color cast on it is so bad. This is shot with the Portra. So compare that to the other shot, and like, the mountains weren't green, so I don't know why everything looks so green. And then we can see here that this was shot even more overexposed than the last one, because there's actual detail down here, and then it's totally blown out here on the treetops. Like, there's no definition at all to these treetops. So it's like, you're kind of damned if you do, damned if you don't. And we can tell that with these shots. Because these are like, it's the same shot, but just a stop or two difference. You can see there's no definition in his face here at all. And then here, you can see his face more, but then you lose all the definition back here. It's so hot and cold like that. This is like the only usable shot out of the mix. And even then, like, what are we looking at here? You know, there's like, and not to say like my photography is excellent and I deserve like the highest quality of film, but to a certain extent, like, I should be able to take usable pictures. Like, I've shot with expired Provia before and gotten better images than this. Like, what is this exactly? This like gnarly coloration here, complete lack of detail here, complete, like, this is just gone right here. There's nothing here. But then to make up for it, this portrait was just incredible. Like, this is probably one of my favorite pictures I've ever taken. I love just the red bob in the middle of the blue here. And this is like, has enough color to it. Again, it was a very sunny day, so this was all kind of blasted, and it was the winter time. I think it was like December. Leaves were off the trees, and there was like white birch trees or something like that. I'm not great with tree names and whatnot, but you know, like, it's definitely a reflective surface. So overall though, like, great trip. And I think the Retrochrome was just kind of a bummer, because I was hoping that that would be like a super cool film, because some of the shots I'd seen were fantastic. So again, I might have gotten a bad batch. You might be luckier if you try it. That was my experience with it. I would have rather shot with something different, or just not shot 35mm at all. So I'm gonna put the sunset footage driving, because I think that's just the most beautiful thing I've ever seen in my life. So here we go. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, let me know. If you had a better experience with Retrochrome, please comment down below. Like, I'd love to hear if there was maybe something I did wrong. You know, maybe it's not as bad as I made it out to be. But yeah, anyway, that will do it for now. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to like it, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And yeah, I think that'll do it. So, appreciate you watching. Catch you on the next one.